to the next one, let's see some weird crush predictions. Come on down! This is kind of where I think my brain pattern is headed. The actual Bobby Darin. I already talk about him a lot on Twitter. I'm disgusting! Dean Stockwell. Hey, he's adorable. I love his outfits. I know Adam Driver will show up in my fangirl timeline again because of the new Star Wars. Steve Allen. Why not? He's the original glasses guy. Neelix. And this cardboard cutout of Barney Fife. And that's all we have for now, so stay tuned. Now, I have seen myself go from a metal and prog rock obsessed girl in my early 20s to a cheesy, corny, nightie wearing, old TV show watching lady in my late 20s. I couldn't predict this would happen. Like, what happened? All of a sudden I hit 25 and suddenly I wake up in an old nightie? I think that's how it happened, actually. I've also exhausted the 1980s for crushes, which I'll get to, so it's inevitable I trolled another decade for some. And it just happened to be the 1950s. And who is our final crush on this list? Buddy Holly! Of all the things that got me into Buddy Holly, it was a Tumblr meme. You kids know the one. But it did get me to listen to Every Day, and I was like, hey, that's a really good song! Even if the thigh slapping sounds a bit creepy out of context.
Good night, everybody!
Then I decided to watch one of the few concert videos of him on YouTube, and oh boy.
Hey, oh boy. Oh boy, the whole world can see that you are a hermit for me.
The glasses, the voice, the teeth! Everything about him was just so cute. Oh my gosh, horn-rimmed glasses are my kryptonite. Hang on a sec, I'm seeing a pattern here. It's so sad he was alive for such a short time because his music is really something special. I suggest the Rarities album and the Not Fade Away box set because they have his earliest recordings on there and you can hear how much he evolved. There's even a children's book on him. They had it at my library. And the artist and the writer definitely got it right. It was so cute. And as of this video, I haven't seen the Buddy Holly story, but I saw a few clips from it, and wait a minute, Gary Busey is playing Buddy Holly?
Every way, love's getting stronger, come what may, do you ever long for true love from me?
And he did well? That's weird. I can't believe it. Well, this is my weird crushes, after all, but wow. The Buse is loose! As much as I see these guys as eye candy, though, I respect their artistry first and foremost. And I learn what they did to get to where they are now and how they cultivated their talent. And their unique talents and personalities are what interests me, more than looks ever will.